Many thanks to Dr. Narayan for inviting me to give this presentation. Actually, this was a case I presented in our monthly dermatological meeting that is held in Sundar Medical Foundation almost every month. This is going on for the last 25 years. One of the senior faculty member from South Chennai, she wanted me to present this, I mean, give these details to Dr. Srinivas. So actually I contacted him for that purpose. Like, because he is every month presenting spotters here. But instead he wanted me to come and give this presentation myself. So, you know, discovery is seeing what everybody has seen and thinking what nobody has thought. I think in a way, clinical diagnosis is also like that, because there are a lot, unless we have the background knowledge, I think we will not be able to diagnose. Especially the word called spotter has devalued the entire dermatology. There is nothing called spotter. It's a spotter for a person who has already known it. Same thing about all the visually specialties like radiology and pathology and dermatology. These are the three visually oriented specialties. The word spotter should be taken out. That has prevented us from learning further. Because that is, these are all the specialties where all these things will come together. Clinical knowledge, pathology, immunology, everything will come together. So that opportunity we are, because we are underrating these specialties, we are not learning. In fact, general specialties and other specialties should know more about dermatology than dermatology itself. And, so without going further, I am presenting these two identical case reports. The time given to me was 6 minutes. I shall try to stick on to that. So it's a three-year-old child who has come in somewhere in October last year to Children's Hospital with a gradually enlarging mass in the right buttock. And there was, in fact, pain and some pain on manifest. It is not at all tender, because every child, when you squeeze it, you will have that pain. Just look at the photograph. This has been repeatedly incised, and an attempt has been made by the surgeons to repeatedly incise it in Andhra Pradesh. After a minute, I'll show you some case from our place where almost similar thing is happening here also. And there is no way better than that. So repeatedly, like in the pretext of drainage, where there is nothing was there. It's a hard mass. It's a hard mass. Look at it. Just look at the photographs. There is no sinus or no this ulceration. Nothing was there. It's a hard mass. And it was this, all this ulcer was created by sinus was created by repeated IND in the, trying to send for pus culture, trying to cure, trying to explore. But it has failed again and again, 7 or 8 times. And the child has come to us. This is the photograph. Just look at it. All the three photographs you can mark. Previous one and all the three. See, that's a 3-year-old child in the right buttock. And if you can carefully notice, you can see this one. This sort of marginalized thing. Very hard. This is what we call as India rubber consistency. It's firm consistency. It is not tender. The tenderness may be because of this incised area over the, otherwise the child was fine. No fever, nothing, no loss of light, no systemic symptoms. Child was absolutely not bothered over, he was playing all the time except on seeing us, because I look like a Raman to that child, because repeated the incision and drain. These are the blood counts were normal. So I think if you have any takers, any diagnosis, just like, see, even I was, I doubt if I had seen this case 10 years back, I would have diagnosed. I don't think I would not have diagnosed this case. I mean, now 21 years after my MD, 22 years after my MD, I think 10 years back, I would not have diagnosed this case. Anybody? It is definitely not cellulitis.
X-ray
pelvis. Why should you take X-ray pelvis in a 3-year-old child?
That's the bone or not?
I can insinuate the finger below the mass. The finger can be insinuated before. That's why I told you that this undermined. Not even undermined, you can insinuate also.
Tuberculosis, sir?
Tuberculosis. That was the reason everybody has explored repeatedly. And luckily they have not given the, because they didn't have the guts to give to a 3-year-old child without interacting with the other specialties, which normally they don't like. No one likes to interact with the other specialties. Because you don't want to lose something. You don't gain anything also by that. Okay. So, they have not given that. Okay, let me show you histopathology. I think this is very, very much part of this. You look at it, at least you can see something red. Look at this, that is the subcutaneous tissue, this is the subcutaneous tissue. So a lot of inflammation in the subcutaneous tissue, which we call it as panniculitis. So this is, I think, this is a classical description. Eosinophilic mass there, eosinophilic precipitate, homogeneous precipitate. That talks about something. I think wherever there are eosinophils, you always think about one drug or atopic disorders or something else. Always think about these three things whenever you have eosinophils. That is very basic. Even in third year we know. Eosinophils means they always think about three things. So that is what. Okay, I will not come to the diagnosis. Then we did a PAS. And I will come to the second case. I will show you the second case. Again, a 2 year old child. In the same, within 3-4 weeks of time from a different place. This child was from the periphery of Chennai. In a very healthy city where it was investigated. This time the surgeons have taken a different route. They have become more cautious being a city. They did MRI now. They did ultrasound, everything. They have done everything, sir, for this case. Ultrasound, everything they have done except putting a colonoscope. Everything they have done. Then they have gone, they have given antibiotics left and right. One fellow will give gram positive, one fellow will give gram negative. You look at the, it will be pathetic if you look at the case history. And no one bothered to show it to any other department. So except contacting their pediatric colleague for dosage, not even for diagnosis. So look at the MRI. MRI is showing something. So they thought it is abscess. So they have said, we have to do it. Paka under thing, you have to get all these PTT. How many times child has taken CVC and all? Now PTT, everything should go and see one senior anesthetist and get his permission, and we will post it for surgery and so much. So they gave a very big list of things. They ran away and came to us, and both these cases we did a biopsy. This case is exactly like this, from a different place. No, they are not related. They do not. Their language is also different. Okay, so look at this. Again, you can see the well-defined margin. Look at it. It's looking a tumor. And surface, they have applied some other thing. So it has become, they have applied some sort of high concentration of aloe vera and all that. Everything you apply aloe vera nowadays, everywhere. Without knowing what is the concentration needed, you apply aloe vera for everything, everywhere. So, aloe vera. High concentration directly from, they have made a concentrate from the paste, aloe vera paste. Everyone will make their own style. So, this is what is happening. So, that is again, see, granulomatous inflammation. Very clear granuloma, you can see the granuloma. See, just giant cells, Langhans giant cells, horseshoe-shaped giant cells. Look at it, much more very clearly, foreign body giant cells. Granuloma, but something eosinophilic is there. Look at it. Eosinophilic microabscesses. So granuloma with eosinophils. That is very, very characteristic of fungal infection. So eosinophils, there are three things. One, atopy. Second is drug. That is eosinophil. All of us have read in the third year also. But unless we see, we will not believe it. Unless, that's a typical thing for, you can see the cross section of the fungal tube cut. And you will see a PAS positive, PAS acid skiff positive, and gumori methylamine silver. These are all we sat with the pathologist, and this is a summary again. A granulomatous inflammation with eosinophils, painless or chronic woody nodule, very large flaw. That's a very typical. This is a deep fungal infection. This is a very deep fungal infection. And you know what happened? This is called a basic duobolomycosis. There's no need to know all the names, because I came to know about it only after interacting with my Chennai colleagues. Because I did do my post-graduation in Chennai through All India entrance exam. I got it only Pune. So here, Dr. Chandramit Shelvi was the person who was taken lot of efforts to.
She is a member of this branch now.
Yes, that's why I did not mention, sir, because once I said Chandramit Shelvi, then everybody will say fungal infection. I don't want to give that clue. In fact, she wanted me to present this case So that's why I contacted Dr. Srinivas. So very typical. You can see by you can see the organisms. So whenever there is eosinophils large amount, you no need to operate that case. And potassium iodide was given. Just it is 100 rupees or something. We made a solution of potassium iodide, and we also gave itraconazole because the patient was so poor that they will not come for routine follow-up. Itraconazole was given. Excellent response. Just look at it within 8 weeks. That is the first child which has been operated for 78 times, and we were the first persons who did not think about, because that woody consistency made us think about basidiomyolysis. Then I took a deep biopsy under local anesthesia, and it's very important to remember that when you get a case like that, you should take 2 pieces for biopsy, one for tissue culture and one for, that is always neglected. You have to take a sample, put it in saline for tissue culture, another sample for formalin. If you mix up the sample in formalin, then phone up the pathologist and convert it to tissue culture, he cannot do anything. That is usually though we shout at pathologists. Next day we want a report from pathologist, but he will keep the patient, you know, weeks and weeks antibiotics for months to that without reason. So that always remember, whenever you have a doubt, go for a pathology. Try to make a diagnosis. Take 2 pieces. Here you should be taken very deep also. And send 2 pieces. Even better, even if you are asking a surgeon to do also, please instruct him to take a deep biopsy. Many times they will take only superficial biopsy. Our pathologist used to call it as pinch biopsy. That is waste. You have to tell them to take, because the pathology is something hard means, inside means. Pathology is the dermis or subcutaneous tissue. These are all very basic things. Okay, second case. Within 6 weeks, completely it has grown. So this basidiomyolysis, I mean, it's simple to remember that there is a subcutaneous fungal infection. Mycetoma all of us know. There is something called this, it comes under this group, entoptoromycosis. You no need to remember the names. It is just a deep fungal infection, a possibility that deep fungal infection, because nowadays we get to know a lot about atypical mycobacterial infection, but deep fungal infection, we find it is very much common in our place. Even a thorn prick or even mosquito bite would have created an abrasion and would have allowed the organism to get implanted. So this is very common. Very commonly there is a zoonotic thing, commonly in the fecal material of lizards and frog and other things. It can also enter through the nasal turbinate, where you get a different form of deep fungal infection. It's called polyomyelomycosis. Okay. So these are all the salient features. Any chronic thing, it's not acute. With cellulitis, you will not get a clear margin. Only erysipelas, you will get a clear margin. Cellulitis is a deeper thing. Erysipelas is dermis. Cellulitis is subcutaneous tissue. That's the first thing. When you have something which is well raised and it is perceptible, then it's not cellulitis. Erysipelas is not that common in our place. Erysipelas is superficial. Where do you get so big a thing? It is very well defined. And it is not painful. And chronic course. So we should think about non-surgical forms of therapy. Thank you. Treatment is I think it's better to you leave the treatment to someone who is interested like Dr. Sanjay, because you have to give it for a long time. Hydroconazole, potassium iodide, 5 mg per kg is the treatment. Potassium iodide, there are 2 ways to make a treatment. One is called supersaturated solution. What here we follow is the thing followed in Madras Medical College. So we get 20 grams and mix up with 1 liter of thing and mix up, and we start with 5 mg per kg, we start with 5 ml and slowly increase, because child may develop iodism also. I think you had a talk about thyroid and all that, iodism. So being a 3-year-old child, first child we admitted, second child we asked the child to come for follow-up every second day initially for the first week, and gradually step up. So we go up to 5 mg per kg. So usually melts away in that. In this patient we have done only that, but because of the difficulty in follow-up and we give both. Normally it is not the thing to give both. Either you give itraconazole. Itraconazole again is a broad spectrum agent. We have to be very careful in using it. Okay. A lot of drug interactions in itraconazole. So we have to be very careful about it. Okay.
Thank you, sir. No, I understand, please. Request Dr. Kasi Sanada, please come forward and hand over the certificate of appreciation to Dr. Ram. Please. So thank you very much, Honorable, for your participation.